Hi, this is Tim from realwebsitehints.com, and this is my review of the Divi 2 theme. I'm going to show you what this theme can do, tell you about who I think this theme is good for, and show you what it's like to use and work with this theme. I spent about 2 weeks building a test site so I could really get in and understand how this theme works and be able to show you what it can do. So let's go ahead and dive right in.
So this is the site that I created with the Divi theme. I got a sense from both the theme and from the Divi theme website that this would be a good theme to use for an internet business website, the kind of website that sells an information product. So for my test site, I created a fictitious internet business that helps people to become better gamers. The Divi theme did not disappoint me when it came to creating this type of website. So let's take a look at some of the pages that I created. Here's the home page. You can see that we've got a full width slider on the top, and the full width slider also features a full width background. We've had a little animation of the text coming in, and that's one of the really nice features about the Divi theme is that it gives you lots of different options to add just little animation elements that really capture the eye of your audience. If we look at the next slide here, because we had an image module which I had slide in, and then the text for the slide in. So just, you know, some really cool, fun features. This theme also features the ability to have full-width background images in any section that you have. So we've got full-width background image, we've got an image module, a text module, and then another image module. Another example of fading in, and another example of a full-width background image that I put in. And here's, you know, another example of the layout features of the theme. And here's where I put the blog section on the home page here. And there's two different styling options for the blog section. And then here I added a sidebar. So you can see that you can add a sidebar to pretty much any place and any part on a page that you want to add a sidebar. So it's, you know, really, really powerful functionality. Let's take a look at the sales page that I made. So here we go. We can see and an image slide in on the sales page. And here's, you know, a little example of the kind of layout that you can do with this theme and the page builder of this theme. You've got different sections along the side here, and then a centerpiece that I put in with a, you know, number counter, again, just grabbing your audience's eye and sort of drawing them to one specific element on your site. Here we've got what they call a blurb section, and you can see it's got these icons here, and each one of these icons is actually included as part of the theme, which is a way that this theme really helps you build sites quickly by giving you lots of great little tools to help you get started. Here's an example of the parallax background, where you can see it looks like the text is moving up and down, but the image is staying back, so a fun little feature, another way of grabbing the attention of your audience, but just adding a different visual element in there. This is another blurb section here. You can see here where I added my own custom image rather than using one of the provided icons, and you can see that the image, when it's up on top, shows up a little bit bigger than it does, for example, like here on the side. And we've got the text, number counter. Another example of, you know, just a full-width background, and I've got a tutorial coming up where I show how I made these full-width backgrounds for use with this theme. Got this section here where you can put in testimonials. You can either have the image of the person or the company that gave you the testimonial, or you can choose not to have it. And then each one of these testimonial sections, you can have a different color background if you want to. It's one of the modules that comes with the website. And here's another great module and really useful if you've got a business that sells a product or service and has different pricing categories, is this pricing table module, which is also part of the theme. So let's go ahead and look at the back end of the website. So this is the back end of the sales page that we were just looking at. And you can see what we have here is we've got different sections. So this here is sort of the standard section look, and you can add, you know, additional rows to it. And each section, you know, where you've got the blue bar or this sort of salmon-colored bar here, each one of these sections is going to have a different background. So whether it's a background image that you have or a background color, or you can actually even add a background video. Let me show you what a background video looks like just in case you're curious. This is from the Divi Themes website. Now, there's lots of different options you have for video backgrounds, and if you're good with video, this could be a really great tool to use to sort of grab your audience's attention and maybe even be able to identify with them emotionally. I've seen some great websites that have used background videos to sort of create a little bit of an emotional connection to their product or service. So back on the back end here, so there's three basic types of modules. I'm not going to go into them in super detail here. This is just a quick review. But each one of them serves their purpose. There's the full width section, which you can use for like a full width slider or a navigation bar, actually. There's a specialty section, which is this section right here. And then there's the standard section, which is this section right here. In the standard section, you add rows, and then you can decide how you want to split up each one of those rows. And there's plenty of options here. I don't see any need for any other options. This is plenty of options to create a great page layout or a great section layout. And then in each one of these rows, you can add modules. So let's just look at the modules really quick. There's the image module, which you saw on the front end of the site. It gives you a lot of options as far as how you want the image to show up, whether you want it to, you know, slide in from one direction or another, or whether you want it to fade in. There's just this basic text module, which uses the WordPress editor, so it's really easy to use, really makes it easy to put your copy on there, give it a little bit of styling really quickly. The blurb feature, which I showed you on the homepage, which allows you to have either little icons or little images next to it. And if you chose to use an icon, you can see here, you click yes to icons, and you get a choice of all of these different icons here that come with the theme. So really helpful just to get you started very quickly. It's really an awesome feature, I think. And then you can select the color that you want for the icon, and you can even add a circle around the icon, and then you can have a separate color for the circle around the icon. So that's just really cool, great feature to help you get started quickly. Got the testimonial option, which you saw on the sales page that I created, and the pricing table option. The call to action option I actually used on the home page. And this here is a call to action section. So you get to use the WordPress editor to create the text up here. And then you get this great, you know, call to action button that's really big. And it's a great way, again, to just help you get started quickly and give you the tools that you need to make a great sales page or a great sales site. Also, with the call to action section, you have the option of either having the background be transparent like it is here, or you can actually have a separate box with a specific color if you want to sort of differentiate that from your background. So if you had a image background and you just wanted this to stand out from the image background, you do have the option of choosing a color for the background of just this section here. So that's a nice feature to have. We've got the subscribe feature here, another really great tool, helps you get started quickly. What the subscribe module does is it lets you create a email opt-in form, which you can use to build your email list either in AWeber or in MailChimp. And you can see here, I've used it on the squeeze page here, which is a feature that the theme offers, which means that we don't have the menu bar running across the top here. Just got the admin bar, which is only because I'm logged into the background. But basically, your viewer would just see just this section here with the background image that I put in, and then some copy that I put into the subscription module, getting people to sign up for my email list. And, you know, you can have as much text here as you want, or as little as you want, or no text at all if you wanted to. And it's just, you know, nice, clean, simple form that will go right into either your AWeber account or your MailChimp account and help you build your list. So great feature to have built right into the Divi theme. So we've got these portfolio modules here. I didn't get a chance to look at these modules in depth for this review, but I've got a review coming up that's going to show you how these modules work and what it's like to use the Divi theme as a portfolio website. Got the bar counter, the circle counter, and the number counter, which you saw on the front end of the website that I created. And then the sidebar module, which you can use to add a sidebar to any section or any part of your website. Really handy feature. We've got the divider option, just to divide up sections between your website. You can either have it be a line or just add extra spacing between your websites. The blog, to add the blog to whichever part of your website you want. And the countdown timer, which is another great tool to have if you're about to launch a site and you're looking for a theme that's going to give you all the tools to help you get ready. Let's look at the page that I made with the countdown timer. So this is the page that I made with the countdown timer. The countdown timer was really easy to use. You basically just put the date and the time that you want it to count down to, and it just starts counting down. And since it's a module, you can really use this countdown timer, you know, for anything. You could either use it, you know, for the launch of your website. So before you've even completed your website, you can have this one page up and ready to go, or you can use it for the launch of a product, and if you want to have people sign up for the latest information about the product before it comes out, you can use that subscription module here. It's just a great tool you can use, again, to help you get started and to help you launch your site and get it ready to go, or launch your product and get it ready to go. Great feature. And that's it for the modules. So I want to talk about a couple of the things that I was a little bit less impressed with this theme. Not necessarily downfalls, but just things that I, you know, something you should be aware of before you start using this theme. One of them is the way that the theme handles your logo. And you can see here, I've got the logo for the site that I created, I put up here. And you can see on the Divi website how they have their logo here. And it works great for this kind of logo where you've got sort of a longer logo than it is tall and it's not too wide. If your company has a bigger logo, you might either want to redesign it or come up with a variant to use for your website just because of the way that the standard navigation module and the place that this theme gives you to put your logo. There are a couple different options for how you can have the menu bar displayed. We've got this, you know, sort of standard option here. There's also this vertical navigation option here. We've got the logo on top and the menu along the side here. Not too crazy about that option just because it keeps the menu here all the time, but some people might find a good use for that. And this here is sort of the last main option where you've got the logo on top and then the menu along the bottom. And you scroll down and you can see the logo gets smaller. So those are sort of the default functions for adding your menu. Now, I did find there's one more way to add a menu for your website if you do have a sort of a different kind of logo and you want to use it kind of in the traditional way. So on the blog page here, what I did is I created this page. I used a blank page template, so it doesn't automatically have the menu structure built in. And then I used the full width menu bar option to add a menu here. So this is one way you can sort of get around it if you like the sort of more traditional website look where you've got, you know, your logo on the side and then some text or some other information next to your logo and then the menu down below. And one thing that you'll notice, though, another part of the theme that I'm not it can work really well, but it's another part of the theme that I'm not that crazy about is how much space it puts around each individual item. One of the things that I found difficult with this theme was if you want to, you know, take a section, let's go back to the sales page here. If you want to take a section like this section here, and you want to have a block here and a block here and a, you know, a couple of blocks here that allow the viewer of your website to sort of quickly scan across and look for the item that they're looking for, there's no real good way of breaking a section apart like that. The sections are really designed to be used like this, where you get, you know, one solid background, and this each section is focusing on one theme, and then you're just providing information on that one theme for your viewers to look at. I think the blog page options also, hopefully the guys that designed the Divi theme will come up with some better functionality with this, but I wasn't too impressed with the styling of the blog pages. You basically have this style here, or on the home page, got this style here where you've got these boxes where each blog post is put in a box and kind of scattered around, and you know, if you make it wider, then each, you know, the blocks sort of fill up all the whole width. I'm not too crazy about the stylings of either one of these. This one I feel like makes a little bit more sense because you can see where the picture goes in relation to the blog post because you've got these boxes around there. But on the standard blog page, it's a little bit confusing because actually, you know, you see this post here, there's no divider between it, and this image is actually part of this post and not part of this top post. So the blog page styling, not that big of a fan of. I think that this is a great theme for a startup or somebody who's starting their own internet business that offers an information product or one or two specific services. I think that with the portfolio features, this might be a great theme for creatives like photographers, videographers, art directors or copywriters. As I said before, I haven't gotten a chance to test that functionality of this theme. I'm going to be doing that very shortly because I really think this could be a powerful theme for something like that. But basically, this theme is really great for individuals or businesses that offer a very clear product or service. So the best things about this theme are its abilities to help you get started quickly, especially if you run your own business, if you run an internet business, or if you've got a small business that just offers one or two services. This is a great theme for that because of the great page builder and all of the tools that come built right into the theme. So that's the look at the Divi theme.
So if you think the Divi theme is right for you and your project and you're fired up and you're ready to go, now is the time to get started. You can find my affiliate link in the description below, or if you go to www.realwebsitehints.com/Divi, you'll find my affiliate link as well as a link to some tutorials I created on how I put together the test site that I put together, plus how I made the backgrounds for the site and the clever tricks I used to pick the color scheme for this website. Now's a great time to get started building your website.